Welcome back. This is John for Lockdown SEO. Before we get into today's topic, if you've been getting value from this channel, go ahead and give it a subscribe. Go ahead and give this video a thumb up. It helps YouTube's algorithm surface these videos more. More people get help. All right, today's topic is how do you create a good piece of content that Google's going to rank? And I'm going to walk you through the steps of my own process for creating a piece of content, for writing a blog article or a resource page that I intend Google to rank. And I'm going to go through it step by step. It's not rocket science. It's just takes a little bit of work, a little bit of focus on each page. But here is the process. Okay, so let's say that you've got a list of keywords that you're trying to rank for your business, or if you're another SEO, you're trying to rank for a client site, but we'll just say that you're working internally for a business and you're trying to rank your list of keywords. Okay, so first thing that you're gonna want to look at is, does Google trust your site? That's going to be a very important thing for ranking future pieces of content. And how can you tell? If you have a blog already going, or whatever you call it, a resource library, we'll just call it a blog. But if you have other things that are ranking for your targeted keywords there, then that is a sign that Google trusts your site. And once Google does trust your site in your selected topic, it's going to be much easier to rank subsequent pieces of content. Now, one of the things that you're going to have to do is, as we've referenced in other videos, look like a big brand, claim all your social media profiles, get links from other industry sites, and write good pieces of content like I'm going to describe here. And if you have pieces of content or blog articles on your site that are currently not ranking, you might want to apply this process to any of them that are not getting any organic traffic, which you can look at in Google Analytics. But this is very important, because once Google starts to see your site as a reputable source of content, good grammar, good voice in the articles, that's a given. Second thing that Google is really looking at is matching the search intent. A big mistake that I think a lot of people have expectations of, or the mismatched expectation that people have, is you want to drive people to your sales pages, like your services pages or your product pages or your sales pages, for each of your individual things, for like all of your keywords. And all of your keywords are not gonna rank for sales intent. Certain times people are looking for a product page, an e-commerce page, a sales page, or a services page. But in some cases, the keywords that you have on your list, they're going to have to be informational content. And how you can determine that, it's really easy, is to just Google the keyword specifically that you're trying to rank. And sometimes, you know, if you add a word or subtract different words, it's going to have a different meaning and it might change the intent. But whatever specific keyword that you're targeting, see what appears there. And I'll give you an example. Say you're a manufacturing firm and you're offering thermal spray services. You might have one page that's a service page for thermal spraying, like the services that you provide in your area. But you might need a separate page of informational content, a blog page, for just the keyword thermal spray, because those are two different intents. And you will see that if you Google each of those keywords, you'll see that. Look at what Google is putting there. If like 9 out of the 10, 10 out of the 10, 8 out of the 10, or even 6 or 7 out of the top 10 results are either a sales page, we'll call it a sales page, but services, product, sales, whatever, that type of page, or an informational page, it's going to become very clear what page on your site you either need to create or form that page into the one that it needs to be in order to rank. Okay, so that's number two, match the intent. Number three, write an outline of the content. This is my process for doing it. It's not super scientific, but it works. You've got the first page results open. Open each one of those results in a separate tab, or maybe even take a couple off of the second page of Google as well. You're going to end up with about 8 to 12 pages of results. Now, what I do, most of these are going to have like an intro, couple paragraphs. At the outro, it'll be like a call to action, or like, you know, hire us, call us, contact us. But everything in between, you're looking for each of those sections. What are they? The little subheadlines for each of those sections on each of those pages that's in the top 10 or the top 12 or the top 15. And you're going to write them down in a Word doc. Just open up a Word doc like where you're making your outline. And you're going to want to put each of the ones that you see. Now, if you see different ones that are kind of over, they're the same thing. They might use a different phrasing, but they're the same, talking about the same thing, and they're kind of matched up. Then you'd put it underneath that. So what I do is I keep a tally. I go through one page, I look at all the subheadlines, and I write all those down. I go to the second page, and then I look at all the subheadlines, and if they match up to the first page, like I said, if there's subheadlines that are, they're worded a little bit differently, but they're basically saying the same thing, then I match those up, and then I'll put a times two by that particular one. I go to the third page and do the same thing, and if there's the same thing on all three of them, I put times three by that particular one. Now, at the end of this process, you're going to see that there are specific sections that need to be in this blog article, because they'll appear more times than any other. And there'll be other ones that, you know, let's say that you open 10 tabs and then you have one section that appears 9 times. You got to have that section in your outline of the blog post that you're going to create, and so on down the list. Now, if you get down to them and there's a couple that only, you know, have the same one like twice out of, you know, 10 or 12, you might leave that out. You might choose to leave that out. If it's mentioned only once, you might choose to leave that out. But all the ones that are mentioned, you know, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9 times out of 10, then you're going to want to put those in there. I mean, that's a must. So basically, you've got your outline, you've got your intro, your outro, and then everything in between is what you need to mention. Now, how you mix it up and how you outline it. I like to write pages where it's like an intro, like, why are you here? Like, address that right away, and then put the different things in an order that makes logical sense, where it's a logical progression. All right. So that's how I do that. I write the call to action. I'll usually write the call to action first, the very last section, the intro, and then I'll just go down the list. And you're not going to want to copy paste stuff from other pages, because that's plagiarism. But you're going to want to express that and teach people in your own words. And you might take note of what these other pages are mentioning. You know, if there's certain key phrases or keywords or phrases, certain industry phrases that get mentioned a lot, then you might want to put that in there. But you're going to want to say these things in your own words, in your own voice. And it's super important to do this as well. But you're going to want to have those sections in there to where you're touching on the categories and the sections of this page that Google seems to think that people want to see there. Now, the reason why Google puts these certain pages up at the top, they're not making a mistake. They are basing this off of data of what people have done before. They see that certain pages people seem to like. And so they say, these pages have all these different, you know, these sections appear. And they mention these certain things and they answer these specific questions. So this is something that you need to do too. You can't just take a wild hair and go off and do something totally different from what's there. Now, if you want to put original research in there, awesome. If you want to take a reference, a study that's been done before, if you notice something like that where it's, you notice like all of them are referencing studies or, you know, things like that, then yes, you're going to want to do the same thing. It sounds really hokey, but this works. Okay. especially if you're on a site that Google already trusts. All right. So you've written your thing, but how long should it be? This is the thing that a lot of people ask. How long should your word count be? Okay. This is really simple. So you're going to want to look at a range of what it needs to be. A lot of people say like the longer the better. Sometimes that's true, sometimes it's not, but I'll tell you how to find the range. So if you Google like word count or a word counter, there will be like various sites that come up. You can basically copy some text, paste it in there, and it will tell you how many words is on that page. Now what I do is pretty simple. I just do Control A to select all, Control C to copy all, Control V to paste it in the word count, and I do that for all the tabs that I currently have open. Now, let's say, for example, that the lowest count page has 800 words and the highest count page might have 2,500 words, but you'll see that the majority of the pages that are there are somewhere between 1,300 and 1,700 words. So you know that your article probably should be in that range as well. It doesn't need to be exact, but you know that you already know that you don't need 10,000 words, and you know that a 300 or 400 word article is not going to suffice. It needs to be at least within the range of what you're already seeing. All right, so that's simple. That takes care of how long should your blog article be. All right, extra elements. This is number five, the fifth thing here. So extra elements, what I look at, again, it all goes back to pattern matching. Google is using machine learning to basically say, like, for this specific keyword, what seems to satisfy people. So these ones that are ranking high and remain ranking high month after month after month that you notice and they don't dip, they have something going for them. So it might be something like, for example, I did an SEO audit not that long ago this last year where a lot of the keywords that the company was aiming for, they were doing formatting the information in tables, and they were doing comparisons of different things, and they were formatting the information in tables. So it's like, that site needs to do the same thing. Another site that I was looking at for their keywords, a certain set of keywords, like all the top ranking pages seem to have a video in there, like YouTube usually. Sometimes it's like a Vimeo, but usually like just a YouTube video embedded in there. It's like, a video needs to be in there in that page because that's what people want to see. Now, there is a really good example of a site that I helped out a couple years ago. There's one particular page with one particular keyword set that they were going for. Now, we redid the page, which was great, the top maybe four or five all seemed to have an illustration that described a concept. So it took us a minute to get an original illustration in there, but we put that in the page. You know, when we rewrote it, it started ranking higher. It was not quite at the top. It was doing better. We put that illustration in there, and then it rose like the rest of the way toward the top. So it's ranking very well today. So it just tells me if you're looking for the elements in there that have to be there, make a note of all these things too when you're looking at the top ranking pages. And again, the reason why SEO tools fail at this, or people who take shortcuts, they fail at this, they want a machine to tell them, you know, exactly what to do. You're not going to find this information with a machine just telling you what to write and what to put and all this. You're going to have to look at this stuff manually if you really want to assess it, and it must be keyword by keyword. Now, some of them, if you have a bunch of keywords that are similar, you'll notice that some of them all kind of have the same pattern. All the pages at rank have the same pattern, so you can put all those like in one clump. But if there's ones that stand out that are different, maybe it's a similar keyword, but for whatever reason, the intent doesn't match the search intent, you would put that in a different clump, and you would probably need to focus on a different page or create a different page to target those particular keywords. Now, okay, once we've done all these five steps, Make sure that Google trusts your site. Match the search intent. Outline your content based on what Google's already ranking and write your article. Check the word count. Make sure it fits within the range of what is already there. And then look for the extra elements that might need to be in that page, and it could be anything at all. I make notes of everything that appears in that page. Oh, this is the last step. This is the sixth step. Now, this is looking for supporting content that might need to be on your site. Now, Google doesn't look at a individual web page just in isolation. They're looking at the rest of the website as well. One of the things that I noticed, I'll give you an illustration, an example here, with supporting content. There is a particular client I was working with this year, and some of their keywords, we focused their pages, and they did better. But one thing that I noticed is all of the top ranking pages for these particular keywords, they linked out to different kind of related articles, or they're within that category of what the specific page was about. But they had supporting content or sibling content, however you want to say it. But there's other pages that are basically within that same family of information. And it's like, these appeared in like basically like three out of every four that's up near the top, or, you know, five out of six, you know, six out of eight that are near the top were these same types of pages on these other sites. So we need to create those pages as well, because that is part of the pattern of what Google is looking for as well. And they were usually linked to down in the bottom third or the bottom quarter of the page. So again, take notes on all these things. The supporting content is part of the pattern of what Google might be looking for with that particular keyword as well. Okay, so now we've got all those six steps. Last step is basically publish it, promote it, make sure you push it out on social, see if you can get visits to it, but most importantly, see if you have industry colleagues that might link to it as a reference. Even if you can get a couple links sometimes in some of these industries, that is going to help immensely. So do all those things. That is all the steps. Google Trust site, match the intent, outline and write the content, check the word count, check for extra elements, check for supporting content and write that content, and then basically publish it and promote it. That, if you follow those seven steps, you are more often than not going to end up with pages that rank pretty well for your keywords. And if you follow that process with every blog article that you do, you're going to end up with a site that Google trusts. Believe me on this. All right. So that is my step-by-step process for writing great content, writing good content. And again, it has to sound natural. Can't sound, wooden or forced. It has to have the right voice. It has to flow. Check how it sounds. Read it out loud, make sure it sounds right. Check all the grammar and stuff like that. But these are the most important elements of good content. This is quality content. All right. My name is John Locke. My business is Lockdown SEO. And again, if you're getting value from this channel, go ahead and give it a subscribe. Give this video a thumb up. And I'm making videos about once a week. I'll come back soon with another video. And that's all I have for now. Until next time, peace.